Hey everybody, it's Friday night in the shop, which is why I look pretty worn down. It was a really big week. So anyways, I wanted to do a video. It might be a little bit long, but I wanted to show you what we do, the sanders we use, the palm sanders. We do a lot of sanding in this shop. We've been going here since 2008, so it's a lot of work. And we use primarily hardwoods, but in the past we did commercial millwork. Lots of solid surface, things like that. So our two mainstays in the shop, just a disclosure, I'm not sponsored by any of these sander companies. I don't work for them. I don't get any money for them. So this is just my personal opinion and experience. So our mainstays in the shop are these Mirka sanders. We actually have three of them. We've had them for a long time. This is the Mirka Saros. That's the original one that came out, right? And it's got a nice urethane here, power cord, that sort of thing. And then the Saros came with the power pack here, which you plug your unit into to get DC power. The reason we went with the Mirka is because they're electric. We have a piston compressor, and we don't want to have that thing banging away all day. Plus, we did a lot of work on site with solid surface, so the electric sanders were perfect for that sort of thing. They're vacuum ready, we can hook up a hose to that, and so we found that they've performed really well. Prior to the Mirka, we had Dynabrade sanders, air sanders. These are excellent as well, they're probably industry standard. And we also have a 3M sander. Pretty popular with auto body shops and that sort of thing. So is Dynabrade. Dynabrade is all kinds of, you know, all kinds of models of the Dynabrade sander. And then more recently we bought a Mirka Daros. I'll just wanted to give you some comparison on the models and what we find with them. And it's probably good feedback for Mirka. We use these sanders a lot. So this Saros, I just did a rough calculation. We've had it about 14 years. We have two of them, and they've run probably about 15,000 hours on each of these machines. And that's being modest, probably a lot more than that. And then this Daros here, it's probably run about 5,000 hours on that machine. So we use these a lot. We don't use the Dynabrade so much anymore. Again, we just have it on the back burner, but it's a great sander. So, and the 3M, we kind of shelved that a little bit while ago. We don't like the orbital pattern on it. It's a little bit too fine on this particular one, and it's a vacuum ready one. So we actually have to block off this because it's just, you know, we don't want to have a vacuum hose attached to that. So it's just spewing. So we don't use that one that much anymore. What can I tell you now? Okay, so I'm going to give you some what we do for maintenance on it. So we have to change the pads every now and then. These pads do wear out, obviously. They actually wear out a lot quicker when you're using the Abernet, the net material. So you do have to have your pad saver on there. Now, one thing that really is super annoying is that these machines are balanced to run without the pad saver pad on them. So there's the least vibration on them is without the pad saver pad. They're designed like that. And then you stick on the pad saver pad, and now you're increasing your weight in here plus your sandpaper, and then the machine becomes out of balance. So it creates a lot of vibration. So that is one thing that I really don't like about these sanders, is because they're a little bit lighter than the Dynabrade. Obviously, this is a lot more metal in here. These are electric motors, so they're a little bit lighter, lots of plastic, and they go out of balance depending on what kind of pad saver you want. So we use a variety of pad savers. We use the thinnest one, which is just like 3 millimeter, I guess it is. We use a little bit softer one, that's a 5 millimeter one. And then we use a 10 millimeter foam one for a lot of curved surfaces. So we use these on a daily basis as well. So that's one thing with both of these sanders, is they do go out of balance depending on what kind of pad you have on them. Most of the time we just use them without a pad, the pad saber pad. You have to blow them out a lot. The Saros and the Daros need to have a good airflow in here to keep them cool. So we blow out the electronic part here. This Saros has been taken apart and put back together maybe a dozen times, so for maintenance. One thing too is the cables break. This cable will break right here inside. One of the cables will break, so you do have to take that apart to get that repaired. You can send it away. We don't have time to send stuff away. It takes forever and it costs a fortune to do it. So we just do all our repairs in-house. We actually bought the kit to take this completely apart, take all the bearings out. So we own that kit and we do all those repairs in-house. But invariably this wire, we actually put a reinforcement right here, and this wire will break inside here eventually. Like it just, it's inevitable, it'll break. So that's fine, it's just wear and tear. Same thing with the Daros. This has a quick coupler at the back here. And as you can see with my red tape, and I don't know if I can get this guy off. There we go. So that's just the quick coupler at the back. So you can store it. That thing will break, guaranteed. So now, if it doesn't break on you, it's probably because you're using it lightly. Like I said, we use these every single day. These things, we run them. So they're in constant use, they fall on the floor. We use them all the time. So it's an industrial setting or a production shop. So anyway, again, this comes apart. There's a little doodad that's goes here, right? That's part of this housing, and that breaks off. Like this bends, that breaks off. This cable breaks inside. You have to be able to take that apart, solder it. It's not a big deal, it's just maintenance. But you know, if you don't know how to solder, then you're gonna have a little bit of a hard time. The bearings, we've changed the bearings inside these as well. The bearings do wear out. There's a main bearing. Unfortunately, with those bearings, and I believe the bearing in here is the same, I'm about to change this one there this weekend. The unfortunate thing, these are double row bearings, and the diameter and all that is easy to find, but a double row bearing that fits in this machine is not available in Canada. So you have to order them from Mirka, and they're like 30, 40 bucks per bearing. In Europe, they're about €4. So if you can get them from Europe, it's gonna be a lot better. But anyways, so that's one thing that I really don't like is the trouble of getting the bearings. I have to buy them from Mirka. So same thing with the Dynabraid. The Dynabraid has the same bearing in it as well. You gotta buy it from Dynabraid, but the bearings come from Europe. So we keep it clean. This whole housing comes apart. This particular sander, we put a little dowel here. It just aids ventilation to get through here to keep the motor cool. So that's why I put that there. Same thing with this jobby. You got to keep it blowing out a lot. They have a lot better air circulation in the Daros model here. There's a little bit more space in here between the circuit board and the electric motor, so it stays cooler a little bit longer. So okay. This particular sander, the two Saros that we bought, they're 10 millimeter orbit. We wanted a very wide orbit with this, very aggressive. Same thing with the Dynabraid. So that's 3/8 on the Dynabraid and 10 millimeter on these. So we got the 10 millimeter. It works great. Some people will say, well, a 5 millimeter orbit would, you know, 5 millimeter orbit would give you a better finish. I could probably sand two things and with the 5 millimeter and the 10 millimeter, and you probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference. But we use the 10 millimeter. We like how it quickly takes off material and it works great. When it comes to the new Daros, they only make a 5 millimeter and that's it. They don't make a 10 millimeter anymore. I don't know why, but that's the way it goes. So. Okay, one thing that I'm going to comment on. So. These two sanders, this sander is extremely comfortable to hold. This yellow part is really grippy. It's really easy to hold. It's just the right size for, I have a large hand, so it's just the right size for me, but it's also good for somebody who's got a smaller hand. And the nice thing is you can hook your thumb right in here, right? And you've got a lot of control. You can lay your hand on top, but it's got this sudden ridge right here. which actually is really good to hold on to. And lo and behold, the DynaBraid has the same design. It's got this nice ridge here that you can hold. So now I don't know who did this, but there's some designers got together at Mirka and they said, oh, we gotta fix that because that's a really good design. That's really easy to hold. So we gotta make something that's shittier to hold. And this is one thing that I would like to point out to Mirka, is that this is like holding a baseball. You hold that for 7 hours a day, the center is really hard to hold. And I know that people are gonna tell me, oh no, no, I got one of those and I can hold that all day long. Okay, you do that for 7 hours a day, for 5 days a week, and you do that 8 weeks in a row. And you tell me if you like that grip better than that grip better. This grip is much, much better. This grip is higher up. The sander is taller. I'd say by, gosh, 3/4 of an inch taller. The diameter of the grip is about the same, but this right here is really slippy. So if you're, it's really hard to hold on to that. That is really easy to hold on to. You can get your fingers right there and it just wraps around your hand. This actually, if you have a smaller hand, you cannot grip onto that very well. If your hand was smaller than mine, you'd be up here. And even with, and so with this guy, the way I hold it is I gotta put my 2 fingers in here to hang onto it. And so I'm kind of holding it like that, which is really, really not comfortable. So that's one thing I really don't like about this sander, is that grip. The second thing I don't like about this sander, it's very high here. And the center of balance is not over the sander, right? It's got a lot of weight at the back here. And it's got a big bulky thing here. So it's a lot longer than this sander by far. So that's one thing I don't like. Now, of course, that's probably the circuit board design because they got rid of the external transformer. So I'll give you that they have to do that. But yeah, I find this is a very tall and long machine. This is an extremely compact sander. It's more compact than the DynaBraid, actually. Anyway, so I really like this sander. I wish they hadn't gone to this. Pardon me, a little bit of dust. But anyways, that's life, right? So I hope somebody at Mirka sees that. And if you want me to test your design, I'll test it. I use these like so much, you know, and especially if you have a glove on. If you have a glove on, like even a grip glove, this material right here is not as grippy as this material right here. This is nice and sticky grippy. You have to keep this really clean to have it grippy. If it gets a little bit of dust on there, it becomes slick. This is a different material as well. This stays grippy. Okay, so that's the comparison with that. So anyways, despite those downfalls, despite those displeasures with those designs, we use these all the time. They are great sanders, but that's just my personal opinion. Some people will have a different opinion, and that's totally fine. We may upgrade our air compressor at some time, and we might go to a continuous air compressor. And in that event, we may go back to using the DynaBraids a little bit more. It's just that we don't like that piston going off all the time. Sandpaper. So we do a lot of sanding on a round. So this is one of our furniture parts, like that. And once it's all assembled, we sand on these rounds a lot. So we'll sand on these rounds, we'll pass the whole assembly through the thickness sander, and then we'll sand on the flats and all that sort of stuff. And then we'll do the ends and la la la. So we do a lot of round sanding. So in the particular part, well, I'll see if I can get a part here now. Okay, bear with me. So just imagine there's a part here like this. Okay, and you got that little corner right in here to sand. Okay, so that's a little bit difficult to sand, and we can't make, this part has to flow into this part. So this is not a very good representation, but the two parts have to flow together. So that's a little bit difficult to sand. So we've tried a lot of different sandpapers, and this is not a criticism of sandpaper manufacturers, but we went through a lot of different kinds, 3M, Sia, whatever, you name it, Mirka, Norton, I don't know, 3M, I probably said that. So we use a, now we found that the one that works for us the best is this ceramic paper by Norton. It's called Dry Ice. Pardon me. Dry Ice. It's a ceramic paper, 100% ceramic. It's not a ceramic with a another blend of abrasive blend in it. 240. And the thing we like about this is it's not a paper and it's not a film. It's almost like a fabric, and on this one, you can see here, like we can get into the corners, and this edge will actually, it'll actually bend up. It'll actually bend around the pad. The pad gets worn after a little while, right? And this will bend around the pad. So we've got that little tiny lip right there that we can get into a corner. Just tilt your sander in and just gently work in there. So Mirka makes a really good product here. It's called Mirka Galaxy, but it's a Mylar film. So it's got the fabric on the Mylar film, and that does not bend well around the pad. It's very, very stiff. So it's good for flat components, but it's not good for round components. Okay, so there's that. We also use a little bit of the Mirka net. The only thing with the net is this stuff eats up your pad, so you have to use it with a pad saver, or else it'll just destroy your pad. Again, it's not flexible at the edge, and if you do happen to bump into a corner with that, or bump in like that, it'll actually fray the edge, and then you'll get all kinds of swirl marks. So we don't like that paper as well. Whereas this particular paper here, the Norton, it doesn't fray like that. It'll more fold, or it'll tear. If it tears, we toss it. But it'll kind of fold, and we can run these a long, long, long time. They have a lot more longevity than like any sandpaper we've tried. So unless there's something else out there that I don't know about, but this one works spectacularly for us. So we've used 3M Cubitron. Again, the Cubitron is a really good paper. It does not have the longevity as the Norton. And again, it's stiff. It's like the equivalent of the Abernet mesh that Mirka makes. So we don't use this a lot. We actually do a little bit of auto body work, and we'll use that in auto body work. So, and what else? Another 3M. This is the 3M Purple Clean, I believe it is. That's a 600 grit. So these work nice. This is very similar in material to the Norton. Again, it doesn't fray, and eventually it can bend around a corner like that. So, but we can go really, really fine on that. Like, that's a 600 grit. And I think that's about it. Hand sanding, we use Carborundum, Canadian made, 150, 220, that sort of thing, 120. Pardon me. And we use the Gold Flex from Mirka. This is really good. These little pads here, we use them for many, many, many years, lots of them. This is a 240 grit to match our 240 grit paper, just for doing little touch-ups and that sort of thing. So that works really well. What else? That's about it, I think. That's all I can think of today, but I just wanted to talk about these particular things. So, you know, if people have suggestions for me, that sort of thing, I'm open to that. This is just my personal opinion. This is just what we do in our shop. And I don't know. I hope that helps. I don't want to discourage you from buying one of these. They're great sanders, but just be aware of the feel. So, you know, I don't want to sway your decision or anything like that, but I just want you, buyer beware, right? So nobody told me. it just showed up one day, and that was it. We just said, we'll buy one, and that's it. And one last thing. We bought this one. Now that's quite a few years ago, and it was $500, and we thought that was a lot of money, right? And now these guys are pushing $1,000. Do I think they're overpriced? Absolutely. Does it cost that much for Mirka to make? I have no idea. So, but it's a lot of money. Okay, so if you average that out over 5 years, right? So that's $200 a year to have a sander, right? But that's a lot of money for a shop to lay out. We can do it because we produce a lot of stuff, but it really burns me a little bit. People will say that Festool is better than these. I don't know. I've never used a Festool. I think they're extremely overpriced as well. That's just my personal opinion. And I don't think I would buy one. Maybe one day I'll try one, but we'll see. Anyway, so we've had success with these, but you guys take it for what it is. Thanks. Hope that helps.